Michael Bulford, and this is Uncut News. Yesterday I said to expect a court case over the recount results. Looks like Anil Nandalal had the same idea. In fact, he has already written the Registrar of the Supreme Court requesting to be heard before any order is made regarding the recount. The former Legal Affairs Minister under the PPPC didn't stop there. He also copied the Registrar of the High Court and the Registrar of the Court of Appeals, just for good measure. So believe me when I say, this recount business is far from over. Continuing with news about the PPPC, officials from the party will be meeting with Police Commissioner Leslie James on Wednesday following the party's request for a face-to-face to discuss matters of national security. On the 4th of June, the PPPC wrote Commissioner James requesting a, quote, urgent meeting on Monday. According to the letter, Jagdeo and friends wanted to meet James to, quote, discuss certain security concerns of public importance, end quote. What those security concerns are, I don't know yet. I am a cartoon, not a mind reader. But we will update you nonetheless. If you've still got plans to go foreign for Christmas, you're in luck. American Airlines is coming back next month. According to the Guyana Civil Aviation Authority, American is expected to restart its services to Chedi-Jegan from the 7th of July. This is 6 days following the four-phased reopening plan beginning the 1st of July 2020. Under the first phase of the reopening plan, there will be limited flights catering for Guyanese citizens, permanent residents, international workers, diplomats, and repatriation flights. Hey, did you know that state-of-the-art GPS is available in Guyana? Contact Triple B's Enterprise. Imagine, someone hijacks your car and tries to use it in a bank robbery. Then, oops, you use the engine shut-off feature and leave them in the sauce. Thanks, Triple B's. That number is 682-8326. Give them a call. Now for crime news. In January of this year, a video began circulating of a fight between two Linden schoolgirls that only ended after one of them stabbed the other with a Rambo knife. Now, the 15-year-old schoolgirl accused of committing the crime appeared before the Linden Magistrates Court charged for the offense of felonious wounding. The girl was placed on $100,000 bail and is scheduled to reappear in court on June 15th, 2020. Friday last, we tracked a story reported on by Big Smith's Newswatch. According to them, the owner of Best Buy Variety Store on the east coast of Demerara told one of his employees to destroy the brand new curb of the adjacent East Coast Highway. Apparently, the Ministry of Public Infrastructure doesn't take too kindly to such ignorant behavior. In a press release, the ministry condemned the deliberate destruction of the road safety feature. Best Buy Variety Store is being held to account for the destruction of public property and will face a fine of $836,299. Ignorance does not pay. It appears that Georgetown residents have a dreadful habit of leaving old cars on city property. As such, the mayor and city council are now urging residents who are responsible for derelict vehicles at the council's property on Princess Street to remove same immediately. The mayor, Pandit Ubrajnarine, told DPI that those abandoned vehicles are delaying the developmental works at the location. Nevertheless, the mayor has already instructed the city engineer to ensure that the vehicles are cleared off. But of course, as any resident of Georgetown already knows, it's not just Princess Street. The whole city is used as a veritable dumping ground of abandoned vehicles, with rusting buckets of boats resting on many of the capital's parapets and reserves. With that being said, here's a tip. The only thing more embarrassing than not having a car is losing one because your broke ass can't make the payments. If anything, you should probably consider going somewhere more affordable. And on that note, ever wondered why minibus drivers are so carefree on the roads? That's because BM Soat Auto Sales makes these minibuses so affordable. Take this, for instance, this pit bull, just 3.8 million Guyana dollars. Check out their showroom at Lot 9 Crow Street, Georgetown, or call them on telephone number 231-8451. Now for education news. The administration of the University of Guyana has recently made history. Professor Paloma Mohammed Martin, PhD, has been appointed as Vice Chancellor of the university, making her the first woman to hold the position since the founding of the institution. Congratulations, Professor. Go forth and make sense out of nonsense that's going on over there. This one's for all of you parents out there who are afraid that this extended break from school is making your children dumber. ExxonMobil Guyana has donated 15 million Guyana dollars to supporting several local programs to help students keep up with their studies during the ongoing school closures. The contribution enables the Rotary Club of Stabroek to team up with local technology services company Brainstreet to provide free online tutorials for students in grades 4, 5, and 6 through its online portal, which can be found at www.braincentral.online. Since internet access remains a challenge for many, the petroleum company is also supporting NSERD's efforts to update and expand its broadcast to schools program on radio and other programs on the Guyana Learning Channel. The resources are there, so if your children fail classes next term, don't blame the Rona, blame yourself. And finally, after leading his company for over 40 years, Roshan Khan is doing the Bill Gates thing. By that I mean he's stepping down as chairman of the business he founded to become its strategic advisor. Khan founded the security firm RK's Guyana Security Services in 1979. Since then, the company went on to make significant strides, including being the first security service to operate in all 10 regions of the nation. Also among one of the largest, with a staff of over 500 employees. Congrats, RK! You've reached the ultimate business goal of getting to quit your own company. Why not celebrate by giving your people them a little top-up on their salaries, nah? Reporting for Uncut News, I am Noriko Bulford signing off.
Hey Guyana Uncut viewers, thanks for checking out Uncut News. Subscribe by clicking on this button down here or click over here to watch more news. Goodbye for now.